So, good afternoon and welcome. Thank you very much for joining me today. My name is Rory Monroe, and I'm one of the solution consultants here at Eureka Solutions. Today's webinar is going to be on NetSuite for leisure and hospitality businesses. Hopefully, today will give you an insightful overview of NetSuite as an application, with an emphasis on why we think it is good for your particular industry and business, based on previous implementations that we've done in this space before. You'll notice that we have a question and answer panel today. So if you have any questions throughout the webinar, please pop them into that chat box there, and we'll have an opportunity at the end to answer any questions that you may have. And if you want a follow-up session at all after today, please get in touch with the team. We can get a little bit more information about requirements, and hopefully set up a more tailored demonstration if you like what you see today. So in terms of our agenda, we'll just kick off by giving you a little bit of an overview of ourselves at Eureka Solutions, in case you're not familiar with us. We'll then talk briefly about Oracle NetSuite as a company and the application. We'll then focus on why we think NetSuite is particularly good for businesses within the leisure and hospitality industries. And then we'll get on to the good bit today, which is our demonstration. So for the demonstration, we'll be going through dashboard and overview, and we'll talk a bit about reporting capabilities. And then we'll also give you a look at NetSuite's procure-to-pay process as well, so that you can have a view of how one of the process walkthroughs looks like in NetSuite. So in terms of Eureka Solutions, we were founded in 1996, focusing on two core principles being technical expertise and customer service. And those two values hold true today. And we hope that that's always conveyed in all of the work that we do, past and present, for our customers. We deal with, of course, NetSuite, which is the reason for you being here today, but we also deal with other applications such as Sage 200 and iPlicit. And we also have our own integration application called Besyncly, which I'll go into in a little bit. In terms of our growth, from having three staff in 2004 to over 70 staff today, our growth has been quite fast and quite consistent throughout the years as well. The majority of our staff members are in technical roles as well, which does emphasize back to our technical expertise. And in terms of customer service, we have our own support teams in-house for each of the applications that we deal with as well. In terms of customer satisfaction, we are proud to say that we have a 9.7 rating out of 10 for customer satisfaction. And as the slide indicates there, the reviews are live on our website. This is done independently through an application called Customer Sure. So after every support case is logged and dealt with, we ask our customers to provide some feedback on any areas of improvement, or perhaps any areas of praise that we've done a good job. So if you're interested in seeing how our current customers view us, then please head over to our website and you'll be able to see a number of reviews there. As I say, the vast majority very positive for us there. We have been a NetSuite solution provider since 2012, and in our maiden year, we achieved the status of EMEA New Partner of the Year due to the amount of new deals and implementations we managed to put through, which was fantastic. Since then, we've successfully implemented 100 end-to-end NetSuite projects, so our experience now within that space is quite vast. And that's across a number of verticals, as I mentioned earlier, particularly within the leisure and hospitality sector. Since then, we've also managed to acquire a number of other notable achievements. We have achieved the NetSuite 5-star Partner Award in 2021, and in that year, we also gained the status of NetSuite UK Best Performing Partner. Since then, they slightly changed the accreditations, and we're proud to say that in 2022 and 2023, we acquired the NetSuite Expertise in ERP accreditation, and we're on track to be performing that again for this year. So we're proud to say that we work closely with NetSuite, and we have been accredited on a number of occasions by them. In terms of Oracle NetSuite as a company and an application, it's known widely as the world's number one cloud ERP system. It was founded in 1998 by Evan Goldberg and acquired by Oracle in 2016. It is a true 100% cloud business management system, unlike some other systems which were on-premise originally and then converted to cloud-based systems. NetSuite was born in the cloud and has always been a cloud application. With this, you're able to access your site on any device, anytime, anywhere. There is, as the image suggests, there also a mobile application, which can be used for a number of things such as reporting capabilities, but also for processes such as entering expense reports and purchase requisitions, and also for approvals as well. One of the key positives about NetSuite is that it is one database for your financials, ERP, HR, and CRM. In a later slide, we've got a nice little diagram which illustrates that for you. But essentially, you're dealing with one source of the truth. So all your information stored in one central database, which eradicates the need for manual entry into multiple systems. NetSuite's storing that data for you and ensuring that it's flowing out to any areas that are required, and all users of your system are gaining access to real-time data throughout the system. Since the acquisition in 2016 by Oracle, this means that the security and privacy is of the highest available tier, and that's because it's backed by Oracle. And if you have a look at the infrastructure that Oracle uses, you'll see exactly how that's engineered and set up, which should give you some surety that given this system has your financial data in it, and that it's completely secure at all times. There's also an availability commitment of 99.7%, i.e., the site will always be available for your use with no downtime. That's the availability commitment, but the actual uptime for NetSuite is much higher than that. I think it's approximately 99.997%. So you can rest assured that the system will always be live and operational for you. In terms of development and enhancements of the system to make sure that it's always up to speed and constantly evolving to meet your changing business needs, the system has an automatic upgrade every 6 months. So twice per year, you'll be notified to say that some enhancements have been made by NetSuite to the system, and they'll allocate a time slot to upgrade your system out of hours so that it's non-destructive to you. So for instance, a lot of our customers recently went through their 6 monthly upgrade there, and a lot of the upgrades are at sort of 2 to 4 in the morning, often at weekends as well, so that the access to the system isn't disturbed for yourself. You'll also be given pre-release notes to ensure that you're up to speed with the changes that are being made, and you'll know if there are any enhancements that directly benefit you in the way that you operate. And of course, if you have the NetSuite Sandbox account, you're also able to test any upgrades that are going to be upgraded into your live account beforehand. We're proud to say that we don't have really any disruption from the upgrades for our customers. We also always find that a very nice and smooth process. But with the availability to test and see the pre-release notes, you can also rest assured that you know what to expect with the system. It's also very positively received by a lot of our customers because NetSuite are always trying to enhance that system, and the upgrades are completely free of charge. So you're getting perhaps additional features which other platforms might need to pay for in terms of an add-on, whereas NetSuite often rolls them out free of charge in the upgrades. A good example of that is Making Tax Digital. When Making Tax Digital became mandatory, NetSuite rolled that out into one of their upgrades as an enhancement, and so all NetSuite customers received that as a free of charge add-on. Some other applications, such as Sage 200, had to pay for that as an additional add-on. So it's a good example of how NetSuite are always evolving their system to be the best of the best for you. And in terms of NetSuite's worldwide usage, it's used by over 30,000 customers, 37,000 customers worldwide. And of course, each of these customers have individual needs, individual numbers of users, etc. And NetSuite's constantly using this data to improve their system, which flows backwards to the 6 monthly update. So it's vastly used across the globe, with very high performance rates reported back from this. In terms of NetSuite's functionality, we'd mentioned earlier that it is a single data source or one source of the truth. So you can see from this diagram here some of the different modules that are available within your NetSuite environment. So of course, NetSuite always starts off with the core financials, but depending on your business needs, you can build this around to add on different sections that you may require, such as human resources, CRM, e-commerce, project management, and a number of other things as well. You'll also notice on the diagram there that it mentions suite app partners. So there are a number of providers such as ourselves that create suite apps which can be used from a store. So if you think of like your Microsoft Marketplace or Google Store, etc., there are suite apps available to take care of any things that might not be completely out of the box with NetSuite. And that's part of the NetSuite development network. So these partners such as ourselves are creating these applications to make sure that you have everything you require at your fingertips. In terms of the NetSuite editions, there are a number of editions that can be available based on your vertical. And with these editions, there's a lot of out-of-the-box functionality that is designed to be suitable for you. So, for instance, with the leisure and hospitality sector, you may find that things like revenue recognition are important to you. So there are a number of ways that we can ensure that you have everything up and running that you require in the initial stages. You'll also notice here on the outer circle of this diagram that you have the ability for international expansion. So whether you're already trading internationally or whether it's something that is a possibility in the future, NetSuite has great functionality for multi-language, multi-currency, multi-country tax compliance, and also multi-subsidiary management. And we have a number of customers at the moment which use this. And we can assist, obviously, in setting up all these legal entities and advising on the localizations for each country. In terms of our Besyncly tool, so this is a cloud-based integration tool which we at Eureka own and operate. It can be used to automate the transfer of data between different systems to ensure that, again, you are using that one source of the truth with NetSuite and any other applications are communicating back and forth with your data. As mentioned, it's developed and supported by Eureka Solutions, so we would be your point of contact there. There are a number of connections already established, as you can see, and this is something that we readily use for many of our existing customers across NetSuite, but also Sage as well. As it's our own platform, of course, it's very customizable and extendable to meet any of your business needs, and it allows us to integrate via an API or flat file as well. So for yourselves, for instance, in the leisure and hospitality industry, you might find that if you are receiving a large number of online sales, you might be thinking, well, how do we transfer that information into NetSuite to ensure that that's flowing through as quickly as possible, nothing's being missed, and we don't have to do manual entry? Well, of course, our Besyncly platform would be able to establish that connection for you. And we could customize to see at which point you would want that data to be in NetSuite. And then from NetSuite, you would be able to transition that through to your billing and invoicing, etc. We can obviously set up individual sessions for Besyncly. So if you think that this is something you'd like a bit more information about, and you maybe even like to see the application, then of course you can get in touch with us and we can give you a look at what that software application looks like. In terms of our NetSuite customers, obviously we have a very large number of customers, as I mentioned, over 100 end-to-end NetSuite projects. But I've picked a snapshot of customers here, which I think is relevant for the leisure and hospitality. So I'll just pick a few out here. You'll see on the left we have Flight Club. So this is an organization, if you're not familiar with them, you've not been to one of their venues. It's a very nice new sort of trendy experience where you can go along and they have an interactive darts game that you can play. So they have computers, etc., which track the darts and you can play a number of different games. They obviously serve food and drink as well. But one of the key benefits of NetSuite that they've found is they have multiple locations all across the country. And for tracking transactions and for reporting, they're able to use NetSuite to consolidate all of their information. To the right of that, we've got Eden. Eden is one of our very large customers. They are an international hotel company. And so they utilize the international part of NetSuite for dealing with all of their different legal entities across borders, and it helps keep them compliant in terms of different tax legislations, etc. You'll see a number of other logos that you might recognize. There's a few football teams in there. We've got Luton Town Football Club, Heart of Midlothian, and also Derby County. They find NetSuite particularly beneficial to them in terms of their reporting capabilities, the ability to tag transactions and to slice and dice their reporting, which I'll show you during the demonstration. And then notably on the bottom right there is Motor Fuel Group. Now, for anyone that's not heard of Motor Fuel Group, they are one of the largest fuel court companies in the UK. So I believe they own and operate around 400 of the petrol stations up and down the country. So it's more than likely that you have perhaps filled up at one of their forecourts in the past. Not entirely relevant to leisure and hospitality, but to give you an idea of NetSuite's scalability, they are approximately a £5 billion per year company, and they are managing that through NetSuite. So whether you are already a large established company or you're seeing a large amount of growth, you can rest assured that NetSuite is flexible and importantly scalable for your business. The last thing that you would want to be doing is committing to a system which you'll then have to change. So we would hope that, like MFG, you're able to use NetSuite for a long time and not have to retrain users on a new system too often. Now, it's all well and good hearing it from me, but I'm sure you'd like to hear some customer testimonials from some of our customers that are using the system for a while and have had the benefit of it. So I have a quotation here from the head of finance at St Andrews Links, which is in Scotland, the home of golf. And I'll give you a wee moment to read this, but hopefully from this you get the gist that they've been extremely happy with the flexibility of the system and its ability to deal with some of the complex scenarios that they have found themselves up against. So, and essentially what this does is based on a number of previous implementations that NetSuite have done and also alongside ourselves, they've taken that information, that data and knowledge and used it to create these out-of-the-box features which lean on your industry's leading practices. And what that does is it gives you a much quicker time to implementation by giving you features such as reporting and process workflows that allow you to get up and running very quickly. And it takes us less time to configure your system for you as well. So in terms of some pre-built functionality, you have things like user roles, dashboards and reports, and also key performance indicators. And as I've mentioned, you also have your process workflows as well. As I mentioned, this is part of their sales and implementation methodology. And essentially what we're looking to do is to get you a quicker time to value and return on your investment. Now, I'll be showing you a standard Suite Success Financials First edition today in NetSuite. And everything that you see today is out of the box functionality. Of course, at Eureka, if you do approach us to further these discussions, we would get an in-depth idea of any customizations that you would need to the system. But the Suite Success methodology gives us a boost in the right direction and ensuring that we can get you up and running and utilizing the system as quickly as possible. So why is NetSuite particularly good for leisure and hospitality businesses? Well, as I've mentioned there, an obvious one is the Suite Success methodology and its pre-built functionality and our ability to get you up and running as quickly as possible. I mentioned the flexibility and the scalability of the system as well, whether it's multiple locations or even subsidiaries across international borders. Hopefully from what you've heard and what you'll see, the NetSuite has that capability to scale and be flexible with your business, whatever your requirements are. It is a very configurable and customizable system. As I've mentioned, it's very easy to extend and integrate, especially through our Syncly platform. And we find the feedback from customers is that NetSuite, when compared to some of its competitors, is a very configurable system by the user. Of course, at Eureka, we can provide training on how to use the system, and you would normally have an administrator or more than one who will be in charge of the setup of your system. But unlike some other systems, like for instance Sage 200, where simple changes to things such as fields and forms require technical expertise, NetSuite is very configurable that way. And hopefully, from what you'll see today, that will be emphasised. Another one which I had mentioned was the automated revenue recognition. So this is one of the many modules and features in NetSuite, which if required for yourselves is available. And essentially what that will allow you to do is to set up automated journaling within the system, so that if you are invoicing and accepting payment for a service, so you'll be of interest to you, as I say, we would be more than happy to demonstrate that in a follow-up session. So we mentioned the support of international expansion, etc. So I'm not going into that too much, but hopefully that's emphasised to you the flexibility of the system. You're given access to real-time visibility through dashboards and KPIs. As soon as something's entered in NetSuite, it's updated and refreshed for every user. So that's just emphasising the real-time access to information. You have the right information at the right time for your business to allow you to make those important decisions. And again, we'd hope that NetSuite is able to automate as many key business processes as possible with its out-of-the-box workflows, such as the procure-to-pay, which we're about to see. And if you're using quite manual, labour-intensive avenues just now, such as spreadsheets for tracking and reporting, then we would hope that NetSuite will enable you to reduce that as much as possible. Now, just before we move on to the demonstration, just to highlight some of the NetSuite proven benefits, which has been taken from previous implementations and customer feedback. We find here, in terms of business visibility, as one of the greatest immediate values of NetSuite. So in terms of 360-degree visibility and actionable insights, we see an increase in between 50 and 80% for customers. Now, I'll not go through all of the financial management ones here, but just to pick out a few from this, you'll see, for instance, the time to close financial books. We see a reduction in 30 to 55%. You'll also see, in terms of account staff productivity, we often see an increase of between 30 and 50%. So hopefully that emphasizes to you how the system is working to automate as much as possible, to prompt users on any actionable tasks that need to be taken care of, and to reduce those manual labor intensive actions that you may be doing at the moment. And so we'll move on to the part which I'm sure you're most interested in, which is the NetSuite demonstration. Now, we'll be going through a bit of an overview here. So for anyone that hasn't perhaps seen NetSuite before, then hopefully this will be a good insight into the system. If you have seen NetSuite before and you are a little bit more familiar with it, then hopefully you can bear with us as we go through this. But we will be going through one of the process workflows being the procure to pay. So hopefully that'll be something new for you if you have seen the system before. So you'll notice here that I'm accessing NetSuite through a Google Chrome browser. NetSuite is supported by all major browsers. So for instance, if you use Microsoft Edge or Firefox, Safari, if you're on a MacBook, etc., you'll be able to access the system from your browser. I have my NetSuite saved here as a tab so that it's easy for me to access. You'll be prompted with the login page here. I'm just going to log into our demonstration account for our Suite Success Financials first. You can also have single sign-on or multi-factor authentication enabled in your environment if that's an additional layer of security that you would require. So as NetSuite loads up here, you'll see our dashboard or landing page. And this is what your users will be presented with on each login to the system. Now, if we navigate to the top right here, you'll see that we're signed in as Andy Morgan, who is the Chief Financial Officer. And you'll also see a number of out-of-the-box roles that are available to me as this is a demonstration account. So we have our administrator, our employee center, and then a number of out-of-the-box roles such as our accounts payable analysts, our account receivables, so on and so forth. We'll be going into a few of these today, but it's important to emphasise that you can set up these roles however you would like them to be. And based on each role and what they would need to see and do within the system, then that can be restricted for each role. So these have all been customised and set up as close to what we think will be required. But of course, as the administrator within your organisation, you'll be able to adapt the visibility and the permissions that each role have if it's not quite the way that you would like it to be. And that's very easy for you as an end user to do as you go. We can also help with that initial setup when implementing the system. Now, of course, in your user environment, these roles will be assigned to your employees as appropriate. So it may be that if it's your sales manager, for instance, they'll only have availability for the sales manager role. So not all of these roles will be available, of course, to all of your employees. In terms of making changes to them as well as the administrator, for instance, if you had a member of your organisation who perhaps wore more than one hat and had to take care of the responsibilities of more than one role, then we could assign more than one role to them, or we could create a custom role, which we could take a copy of the closest role to them, and then we could obviously add on anything that they required as well. So hopefully that gives you a wee idea of the flexibility of the roles and how we're trying to streamline the visibility and access to. If I type in here, start typing, I'll start to get a number of results within the system. We can also use custom prefixes here to filter down information. For instance, if you were to start typing in customer and then follow that up with a hyphen, we would be able to filter down customers to quickly access those records. We can also use our conventional drop-down bar here as well. So for instance, to navigate to customers, I could quickly come to this tab, to lists, and down to customers. And I could either create a new customer or I could go into the list of existing customers that we have here. On the left here, you'll see we have our recent records. So if you've recently been put through a bill or an invoice or dealing with a customer, then you can quickly navigate back to that without having to go through the traditional drop-down menu bar. We can also click here to view all of our recent records as well to expand that out. If there's any pages within the system that you find yourself using regularly, we can add it in as a shortcut here, which is very easy to do. For instance, for the Chief Financial Officer, you'll see that I've added in the profit and loss statement and also the customer record here as well. So these are quick navigations. We can click on those and they'll take us directly to that point within the system. In terms of our dashboard here, you'll notice that there's a number of white boxes. These are all known as portlets, and they can be easily customized and moved around the system as we would like to see them. Your dashboards can be created for each role and then locked by the administrator. So, for instance, if you wanted to set up a sales dashboard that should be used throughout the system without change, then we could create a sales dashboard which brings all the information required to that role, and then we could lock it there so that it's consistent throughout the business. However, if you want to autonomize that and you want your employees to be able to customize their dashboards to suit their preference, then you can also give them that autonomy to do so and ensure that they are working to the best of their abilities with everything they need at their fingertips. In terms of going through some of the portlets here, you'll notice at the top left we have our reminders portlet. So this is showing me any actionable tasks that I have to do as the CFO. So for instance, any vendor bills to approve, expense reports, etc. You'll notice here that we have a reminder set up for invoices which are over 30 days old and of a high value over £50,000. This is a saved search which is out of the box and has been set up in the system for a specific thing that we might want to view, and it's been brought forward to the reminders portlet for the CFO, as that's maybe something that you would want to keep on top of. And it gives us a bit of an idea on how we can easily create saved searches for very specific things within the system and then bring them to the forefront of our attention in the reminders portlet. These portlets are also customizable. So, for instance, with the reminders portlet, we can go to the three dots. We can click on setup, and we can see here that we can easily drag and drop to customize what we're viewing here as well. We can then also click show reminders with zero results if we want to expand that out. So you'll see here we've added in customer access, but we don't have any here to view, which is absolutely fine. If we go back to setup here and we decide actually I don't want that, we can quickly delete it with the red X. And we can also untick show reminders with zero results to revert back to where we were. And so we can set up custom saved searches within the system, but there are a number of out-of-the-box reminders which should sufficiently allow your users to deal with the tasks that. Hello everyone, I do apologize. I appear to have lost connection there whilst doing that demonstration for you. So we'll just try and quickly come back in and pick up where we left off. Apologize for any inconvenience caused there. As I'd mentioned, we can set up follow-up sessions for you to go over anything. So we can spend some more time with you in ensuring that you've got a good grasp of the software and that any questions are answered for you. So we were just going through the dashboard here and I was explaining how our reminders portlets push through those actionable tasks for us to ensure that our users are constantly being reminded of things that need to be actioned and perhaps passed on to the next person within our organization. And of course, those can be easily set up to add in and take away reminders as appropriate. And we have a large number of out-of-the-box reminders which can be set up. We have our navigational tiles here in terms of our different reporting functionality, and we have a lot of financial data coming through. This is the CFO role, so we want as much high-level information as we can possibly get here. We have our key performance indicators portlet, which is set up with some of our key financial data, and we also have some drillable points as well here where we can go in and see the report that is pulling from. So for instance, here we have our sales. We can see this month's period versus last month's. And we could, of course, drill into that information and go right down to the transaction level. And here we're given an idea of the percentage increase and decrease as well. To save you needing to navigate to that specific report, you'll be able to see it on your dashboard here. We have a number of navigational shortcuts, which are all set up based on your role and what you would need to access within the system. And you'll see that we have a number of different trend graphs throughout and report snapshots. This is all pulling through the most relevant data to you to ensure that you've got it at your fingertips and that you can make those decisions within your organization as quickly and as well informed as possible. So just going into one of our reports here to give you a look at how that looks in the system. If we go ahead and click our navigational shortcut tile for profit and loss, you'll see that it's utilizing NetSuite's browser functionality and it's opened that profit and loss or income statement up in another browser for me so I can quickly navigate back at any time here. So you'll see here we have a look at our income statement and our chart of accounts. Now, NetSuite has a very flexible chart of accounts system. You can have as many as you would need to be set up, and you can obviously have these numbered and named in any way that you would like to have that. And if we scroll down here, you'll see some of the demonstration data which is available. You'll also notice that all of these figures are drillable as well. So if we go ahead and click into the detailed report for revenue, you'll see that we get a lot more detail of the individual invoices, memos, and journals that make up this total figure. And for instance, if we wanted to go into an invoice as well, you'll see that we're able to drill right down to the transaction level. So I can see that invoice. And the customer that it refers to. We can see a number of other data available to us right down to the line level here as well. And if you were counting the clicks there, then that was three clicks from our home dashboard right down to the transaction level here, hopefully saving you time and searching through the system. So going back to our income statement here as well, we have the ability to configure the view and the period that we want to see. So at the moment we're viewing this period, but I can quickly go in and select a different period to view. For instance, we might want to view it by the last fiscal year. So we can click on the quick filter and we can go down to last fiscal year. And you'll see that there are a number of out-of-the-box periods, but we can also set a custom date range if we would like to, and we can alter the from and to dates here. If we go ahead and click last fiscal year and refresh, there's no data available for that fiscal year, given that it's a demonstration environment. But if we pick a better period than that, let's just go to last period, and you'll see all of that information flowing through. We also have the ability to look at it from a subsidiary level. So we'd mentioned earlier in terms of having different legal entities and across internationally, then we can view our reporting in any way that we would like. So for instance, we're currently looking at the parent company consolidated level, which takes in all the figures across all of our subsidiaries. But for instance, we may want to just view the United Kingdom, so we can quickly select and hit refresh, and all of that information will pull through from that subsidiary. We talked about multiple currencies across different countries as well. So if we view the Netherlands here, you'll see that that information is being displayed in euros. Now, in terms of NetSuite's exchange rates, you have the ability to have that automatically imported, and that can be assigned against the rates set by HSBC or Exignite. And that's a daily update on your exchanges to ensure that you're given the most up-to-date information there as possible. And in terms of your parent company consolidated, this will always be reported on in the base currency of the parent company. So, albeit this is comprised of the Netherlands as well, the system is automatically converting that based on today's daily exchange rate, which for the purposes of this demo is assigned to HSBC's daily exchange rate. And in terms of our column here, you also have the ability to report on a number of different things within the system through what we call custom classifications. So you have a number of classifications, three in total, that are out of the box. We have it by class, department, and location, but you can also create an unlimited number of classifications which allow you to tag those against transactions and to slice and dice your reporting under a number of different ways. So for instance, if we go and click department here and refresh, you'll see how we can view our income statement across all of the different departments, which just gives us a deeper, more granular level of data. We can also do that by location. So if you have multiple locations, then you'll be able to distinguish between the locations, and you'll also be able to see that as a total here as well. If we go to class and refresh, you'll see here that I've put in a little example of how you could slice and dice that information. So this is perhaps a good example for any companies which operate in the hotel or events space. So here what we've been able to do is set up custom classifications for wet being your drinks in the AM and the PM, dry being your food, AM and PM, and we've also put in weddings there as well. You could expand that out to other events such as concerts, birthday parties, etc. And that's just an example of one thing that you could expand your reporting on. But of course, anything at all that you would need to do that, whether it be the services that you provide, then you'll be able to set as many custom classifications as you need and to tag your transactions. And what that allows us to do here is have a much more streamlined chart of accounts. There's less need to have a complex hierarchy of accounts and more availability to have that horizontally here. And we can still take advantage of that in-depth reporting capability. Now, in the time that we have left, again, apologies for the technical jolt there. We can go a little bit past the time, but of course, it will be recorded for anyone that's got a hard stop at 3 p.m. I just wanted to give you a quick look at one of the process walkthroughs, which is the procure-to-pay process. So if we navigate to the employee centre, this is a stripped-back license type. Now, the license type that you saw before was our general access, which has much more visibility within the system and much more ability to put in different transactions. Employee centre licenses come in packs of five and are relatively similar priced to the price of one general access. So if there are some employees within your system who perhaps don't require the full functionality of NetSuite, they may be only required to enter purchase requisitions and expense reports, then this may be a more cost-effective alternative for those employees. So here you can see we have the ability to enter in purchase requisitions, and we're prompted with our purchase request form. All of these forms that you see in NetSuite are fully customizable, so if there's any fields that you wouldn't require or you would like to add in additional ones, then that's all very easily configurable, and that can be done by yourselves with training. So here we're being prompted to add in a vendor or supplier. Americanisms such as vendor, etc. can all be changed and customized as well to whatever terminology that you would like within the system. So as an employee and user of NetSuite here within the organization, I can go ahead and click whichever supplier it is that I'm requesting this from. Of course, if your employees maybe weren't sure of what supplier, then we could put in a dummy supplier here, which means that when it goes to the next approver, they'll be able to select that at that point with the most appropriate supplier for the item. So we'll go ahead and put in Baymania as our supplier, and then we're being prompted to add in a location. You'll see that a number of other fields are being automatically populated, so the purchase order number will be generated by the system. The subsidiary of United Kingdom is pulling through from my Abiquan employee record so that I don't have to enter that manually, and today's date is of course set for today. If I needed this to be received by a certain date, then I could put the receive by date here. And our currency is also being pulled from my employee record. In terms of our item, we'll go ahead and scroll down, and you can see there's a vast number of items that are available. Obviously, these would be set up based on any items that you currently have or would require. And you can have a vast availability of, for instance, non-inventory items or inventory items. Now, for the demonstration, I'll be putting through a non-inventory item being a Dell laptop for internal use. But of course, if you did require any items to be purchased which needed to be tracked throughout the system, then that is completely fine. If you were tracking any items as stock, then the system would be able to do item receipt and then to bring that in and track that in your inventory for you. And you'll see all the information that's been pulled here from the item record being a description, the department and the class in terms of our reporting capabilities. We don't have any on hand or available as we're not tracking this as stock. And you'll see the rates and the tax codes that are being pulled through from the item record as well. So we'll go ahead and click save, add rather, and then save to that purchase request. Now, NetSuite has standard approval routing, so this will then go to our supervisor for approval. We can set up more customized workflows if required. If you perhaps wanted that to go to, for instance, departmental heads, then we can create those workflows for you to ensure that that's set up the way you would need it to be. So we're just going to navigate now to the next approver, which is our financial controller, Carol Morgan. And we should see so in our reminders portlet here, we have the ability to see any purchase requests to approve. So that's automatically generated that through and is prompting me to action that. And we'll see here that that purchase request that we have just put through is now at a status of ready for approval. So if there was multiple ones here, we could mark more than one and approve them at the same time. But for this, we just have one, so we can click on the date hyperlink, which will take us directly to purchase requisition. Now you'll notice here that the system has generated this as now a purchase order. So once I approve this as the next approver, that will automatically be put on as a purchase order. So I have the ability to check this here and to make sure that I'm happy with all the information. If I needed to make any changes, I could edit it. If for any reason I wasn't happy with it and I needed to reject it, then I could click reject and I could provide Abby Kwan with a reason for rejection. And it may be that she's given an opportunity to make or correct a mistake and then to resubmit that for approval. But for the purposes of this, we'll go ahead and approve. Now, within NetSuite, we also have the option of two or three-way match. So if you did need that three-way match functionality in terms of item receipts, then we could have that set up. For instance, the inventory manager could track that once it's been received. But as this is a non-inventory item, we would then go directly to billing. And within the billing page here, you'll see that we've selected our purchase orders to bill, and we have a number of different ones here. If we scroll down to today's, we can see the purchase order for Bay Mania, and we can go ahead and click the hyperlink through to that purchase order. We can see that it's at a status of approved by supervisor and pending billing, and we have the option to edit any information. Now, to give you a look at how the bill exception works here, we can go ahead and click bill. And we'll be prompted with our bill stage. We'll be asked for a reference number. So of course, that'll be set up however you would need that to be internally. But for the purposes of this demo, we can just put in a random invoice number. We can see here that it's also a status of pending approval. So after this, it will go to our CFO for approval. And to give you an idea of how the bill exception works on our two-way match, if, for instance, this was to come in at a higher rate than we had expected, then the system will take a note of that and will create a bill exception to notify us of the change. So I'm going to increase the rate from 806 to 820, and we'll see how the system deals with that. So we'll go ahead and click Save on the bill, which will put that through to the next approver. But we should see there a bill exception to let us know that there has been a change from the original purchase order. And as mentioned, we have our bill exception here. And we're given a reason for that. We can see that the bill amount has exceeded the purchase order amount. So if that was a mistake, of course, we could go in and edit that and correct it. Or if it's just that the prices had been increased and we hadn't perhaps been notified, then we can quickly and easily see that information there. So we'll now move to the CFO, which is the last stage in our approvals. And we'll see here that we have a supplier bill to approve. So we'll go ahead and again click our invoice, our reminder rather, and go to view. And we'll see that we have the ability to view, if necessary, edit, and then finally approve. And we have the ability to view that bill exception as well to ensure that that is correct. And we now have the bill at status of open. So this is ready for paying as well. Now, the last step in this process is to make a payment run. So within NetSuite, you have the availability to create an export a BACS file, which can then be uploaded to your bank for payment. And it allows you to pay multiple bills or expenses, etc., at the same time to save you the need to do that manually across multiple bills. So we can go ahead here and click our bank account. And from our bank account, that will be now populating the information through to this form, such as the subsidiary, the bank account format, which is BACS. We can also support other bank formats. So if there's any specifically, you can let us know and we can ensure that that's supported. We can choose our accounts payable account, which in this case is our trade creditors. And all of those bills to be paid will now be pulling through from the locations. We can pick the transaction type to filter that down as well. So we can click bills. And we can also filter that down by supplier as well if we wanted to narrow our field. But if we just scroll down, you'll see that there's lots of demo data for bills here. So we have a number for Bay Mania and some other suppliers there as well. So we would then have the availability to click submit. The system would process that and create a BACS file for us, which we could export. And then, as mentioned, we would be able to upload that to our bank for payment. Now, I think we've just managed to get through that with the time that was left, bang on 3 o'clock. But as I had mentioned earlier, we'll have an opportunity now for any questions. So we'll just go through to the last slide here. So hopefully, if you had any questions during the presentation, you were popping those into the chat box for us. So if you bear with me, I'm just going to get that chat box up and have a look and see any questions that have maybe come through. Okay, so we've got a question here to say, how does NetSuite handle the foreign exchange conversion where the group has a different reporting currency to some of the subsidiaries? So I think the question there is, if we have multiple subsidiaries and a consolidated parent group which is using different currencies, then how do we consolidate that? So the way that it will be set up, you can have multiple different currencies being exchanged. So you might have a subsidiary in the Netherlands which is using euros. You might have a subsidiary in Sweden which is using krona. So it can simultaneously convert any other currency into the base currency of the parent consolidated company. And then you will have your consolidated reporting functionality. Hopefully that answers that question. I'm just going to read it one more time to make sure I've understood it correctly. So the other thing to mention there is when you're talking about the different currency for the consolidated level and the subsidiaries, you can obviously report as I'd shown down on the subsidiary level. So if your subsidiary is in the Netherlands and you want to report on it at that level, then you will be able to do that and you'll see it in that currency. Whereas when you go to your consolidated view of your parent company, then that will automatically transfer it into the base currency. But you'll be able to distinguish between all the different legal entities and currencies that you have within the system. Obviously, if there's maybe a niche requirement there and the reason for the question, then if you can't get in touch and approach us, we'll be able to understand your specific requirement and let you know exactly how the system would operate that for you. So just waiting to see if any other questions come in. If you have any questions and you're still there and available, please pop them into the chat box and I'll do the best of my ability to answer those for you. So I've got a question here about our Besyncly platform. You're saying that you use Procure Wizard just now, and asking whether we can integrate that. I believe that we have integrated with Procure Wizard specifically before for previous customers. So I know that that is available through our integration platform, and we would be able to automate the import of any information from that platform to NetSuite. I believe Procure Wizard now have an API connection, so we should be able to do that through API. But of course, we can have a look into that for you and ensure. And that goes for any other applications that you might be using where you want data imported, whether it's a one or two-way flow of information between the platforms. I have another question about how long would it take to get live with NetSuite? So that varies, of course, based on your requirements. We would obviously ensure that we are completely understanding of what you would need to have up and running in the system. Now, with the Suite Success methodology, what we're trying to do is to get you up and running live as quickly as possible to get that return on investment for you. So we'd put in place the very basics of what you require for that. So that's your core financials. And then after that, in future phases, if you wanted to add in things like human resources or CRM, etc., then we'd be able to do that for you. But to try and give you an answer, our sort of typical implementation time at the moment would be around sort of 4 or 5 months, based on a kind of standard implementation. But we'd be able to give you a much more accurate idea of timeline after speaking to you as well. And obviously, if you have a sort of target date in mind, then we can try and work towards that for you. So, as I say, please reach out for more information. Apologies again for the technical glitch there with the connection, but we'd be more than happy to set up a similar session for you, which is a bit more specific to your requirements, and hopefully, you'll be able to see how NetSuite would work for your business. Okay. So I don't see any more questions in the chat box just now. For anyone that's joined us today, thank you very much for your time. Really appreciate you coming along to the session today. Hopefully it was informative for you. And if you haven't seen NetSuite before, then hopefully it was a good insight into the application. We hope that you agree that there's sort of infinite possibilities with the system, and we'd hope that Eureka Solutions would be a preferred partner of choice for implementing this for you. I'll hang around for another couple of minutes, just in case any questions come through. But otherwise, feel free to drop off and please do get in touch if you've got anything after the session today that you want to discuss with us. So I'll hang on for a minute or two, but otherwise, thank you for coming along today.